Hi guys, and welcome back to Popcorn Simulation Gaming. Now then, we're back on the lake. We're in the van, we're all ready to go. This is the third one in the series. So yeah, let's crack on. Let's get our deliveries done and let's see what the story entails. Hiya Bobby on Twitch, thanks for coming in matey. Lovely to see you, as always. Now then, we've got a letter up here, look. Guys, I must admit, I've done one drop-off, which was to the Fag Ashlil that runs the grocery store. She's just a moaning old sod. It's not that one, it's up here, isn't it? Walk her a bit faster. I've got to say, every time I come into this game, it is charming, isn't it? Poor lass, she's getting bloody piss wet through, look. I am using a new mic, guys, so I hope it's alright. We'll see how it goes. Be a bit of a test on this one. Yeah, the mic on this one's the official Xbox headset. Read really, really good reviews on it, but I'm not so sure. Not for the test I've just heard on Twitch, but we'll crack on. We'll keep going. About the game, not the mic, isn't it? Right, we're down here, look. It's charming, isn't it? And we have got weather. Of course we have. I've just realised, guys. Questioned that the last one, didn't I? Whether we'd got weather or not. We have. Fantastic. Not that one. But that one. It's not this one, is it? No, hang on. Come on, get your mailing, girl. It's that one. This is as fast as she walks, I'm afraid. I can't get her going any quicker. Now then, there's a video store there, look. There's mail there. I wonder if we get notified when the... Oh, there's not one at the video store. We can go straight up though, love. I wonder if we get notified when the van's ready for breaking down, or do we have to just take it? And petrol, I'm not sure. Oh, is it... No, it's a letter. Little bit unresponsive when I'm asking her to get back in the truck there. Takes a couple of goes. So we're going to go left down, past the video shop, and then right, aren't we? Oh, it's not that one. I was reading the 202. It's telling you where you parked, isn't it? Nothing here, is there? So, okay, that's the first parcel there. I've got all my bags packed up, ready to leave. Gotta say, the music's pretty chill on this. Hiya, Mr. Cook, welcome in. Nice to see you, matey. I was just saying to Bobby there, who's on with us, yeah, I'm using another headset. I'm using the official Xbox, and I'm not too sure about the mic, I'll be honest. It's supposed to be better than the Turtle Beach Shield Pro 700. I don't know. I'm trying it out anyway. I hope it's okay. I had a bit of trouble setting it up, actually, so... oh, here we are, we're at the... oh, can you fill up? Can you actually fill up? No, it don't look like they're going to fill us up, does it? Oh, that's fantastic, thank you. I feel like I don't have to shout in these, I'll be honest. No, you didn't. I'm talking to Mr. Cook. Stop bitching, get the package and drop it off, please. I'm having a private conversation with Mr. Cook. Now then, what address are we at? I didn't even check the bloody address. Where are we? 300 Lake Road. We are 300 Lake Road then.
That's lighter than I thought.
Go on, give it a check, see what's in it. Said that before. We could steam it open, couldn't we?
Hi, Lori. Got some mail for you today.
Oh, hi, Miss W. Yeah, thanks.
Something on your mind?
Oh, it's nothing. Don't worry about it.
Are you sure? You seem out of it.
It's just... Angie came by with a movie box and a couple of movies to watch. The Love Bug and A Nightmare on Elm Street.
Oh, did she? I'm not surprised. And you're having trouble picking?
Ugh, I don't. But if my parents catch me watching Elm Street, they'll ground me for a week. I wish they'd just take a chill pill and see that I'm basically an adult. I fix cars.
Oh, no, that's too bad, Lori. Maybe you can watch it at a friend's house instead.
No, I'm homeschooled. There aren't many teenagers here, as you may have noticed. So I don't really have any friends to watch it with. So it's a Love Bug for me.
Oh, go on, let's watch Nightmare on Elm Street. Let's be daring.
Tell you what, take the Love Bug now, and we'll watch the horror movie at my place. Would Sunday work for you?
What? Really? Yes, it would. That'd be wicked, Miss W.
Of course. I'm always in for a good fright. So, see you Sunday?
Totally. Thanks so much.
Deal. Have a nice day.
And don't forget to put your rubber gloves on, because you're going to be scrubbing the house out. You're going to get the Hoover out, the duster out. You're doing the lot, missy. Don't think you're just coming and sitting on your ass. What is that? No idea what that is. We'll take a look at that. They've really spread out. Oh my god, we've got a bit more map there, look. We didn't have that in the game last time, did we? Oh, right, okay, so there's none there. There's one there. One here. We may as well just go the whole way round, hadn't we? Over the river, and then the next right. Okay. Sorry guys, I'm just getting my bearings. Charming, very, very charming, very chilling. I know Mr. Cook, she thinks she's just going to come round, but she just to like sit on her ass all frigging day. She can empty the dishwasher and put bloody washing in while she's there and all. So, Mr. Cook, do you ever get back to Scotland? Do you ever get back to the UK, or are you out there? That's very expensive, isn't it, the flights? I know, because we fly into Montreal. As I think I told you, we visit Maine a lot. But yeah, the flights are terrible. Do you know when we were playing Bus 21 the other night? This is definitely Bus 21 graphics, but better, isn't it? It's like the next version along. That's how I see it anyway. It feels like that. Right, we're going. Not that one. This one here, aren't we? Oh, that's lovely. That's
now
really sweet.
Is it time to leave Providence Oaks?
Oh, have I took wrong frigging turning? Let me have a look, guys. Where we gone? Oh, we ain't even gone over at frigging water, have we? Right, okay. Sorry, guys. Bit of a U-turn. Am I the two bleeding late? And I have to stop trains in or in a car, I'm too friggin' early. Yeah, that artwork over there is pretty, isn't it? Over the lake. Look at that. Really nice. Right, we've got to cross a bridge, guys. And I promise I'll try and stop talking when the storyline's on. Lovely voice, I could listen to her all day. Oh, it's not what we see. This is a new address, guys. Yeah, look at the popping in. Friggin' hell. Don't look at it. Don't look at it. That looks like the Amateurville, doesn't it? Oh, we'll get some gossip here, guys. You watch.
That's lighter than I thought.
Oh, bless you, 22 minutes on it. Mine's not working on bus 21. Did you see my video?
Hello, sir.
I reckon that's a parcel with my name on it.
If your name is Jack Reynolds? Indeed.
Indeed I am. And I reckon you're the new postal worker?
No, I've come to clean your windows, love.
Indeed I am.
Well, thank you much. New around here, I reckon. People call me JR. I'm a farmer and DJ.
I'm Meredith. Nice to meet you. DJ and farmer? That's a rare combo.
Indeed it is. But it's a nice distraction from farming. I've seen better times. I had some spare time and a room in the shed, so I figured, why not?
About your playlist. I think it could use some more songs.
Indeed, indeed. Working on that. But I'm in the middle of a potato harvest. Don't have much time. Hey, listen. Postal worker Meredith, I need to get back to work. Can you do me a favor and give this envelope to Frank?
I'm afraid it would need a stamp first.
Oh, well, I'm afraid I don't have them here.
I'm gonna sell him a stamp. I'm gonna sell him a stamp. He's not getting away with this. He's a rich farmer. Always says they've got no money.
I can sell you a stamp right now if you want.
Don't have cash on me right now.
I'm sorry then. Can't do it.
Oh, okay. I'll just drive my tractor over to Frank's later tonight.
That's it. Spend your own bleeding petrol money. Lovely big bird just going in there, look. That looked cool. Yeah, they're all trying it on, aren't they, these little villagers? They'd have her running ragged, wouldn't they? I'll tell you, there must be a thousand different ways of this storyline. Oh, we're back at the diner. We're off to see our friend that lost her uncle 10 years ago and still got a grudge with her because she never phoned her. Right, Ollie, if you're watching, I'm going to try and park it for you, mate. That'll do. Just over the line, though. You guys down for blueberry pie? I bet she offers it again. We haven't had a bloody piece yet, have we? We've never got a chance to. Oh, I bet it's not. I bet it's Cyril's got the grudge.
Hi, Kay. Delivery for the diner.
Hey, Meredith. Sure, just put it on the counter, would you?
Kay, about the other day.
What about it?
Why were you upset to see me?
I don't know. Maybe because you never replied, even though I wrote and called you?
Yeah, you're holding a grudge.
Wow, way to hold a grudge.
Wow, really? You know what? I think this is still not the time to talk about this.
Actually, I was just dropping off the package. See ya.
Sure.
Ooh, no, cutting. Fight. There's gonna be in there. There'll be nails and hair pulled out before midnight, I'm telling you. Right, we're off back to the post office. Yeah, we'll get these proper fighting. I believe it is actually, but do you know what I reckon? I did see their Dev's video, a little bit of that in the fork truck. I reckon it'll come steam first, won't it? I'll check for you though, Mr. Scott, definitely. Excuse me, I'll check for you, matey. I'll have a look at that. Got hiccups, sorry. Yeah, I'll have a look at that. I'll tell you what, the graphics on that look pretty cool, don't they? But as we were talking in the live stream the other night, well, we didn't know we were live on YouTube, but we were when we were on with you guys. It went live and I didn't know. But yeah, the paramedics are coming out, aren't they? That simulation paramedics, that looks pretty cool. Yeah, that looks gorgeous. I know it's popping, but look at that. That looks really sweet, doesn't it? Really, really nice. I hope there's some sequels to this, actually. The storyline's just slightly a little bit slow. We need to get them all fighting.
Well now, Meredith and Robert. Welcome to Moe's. Table for two.
Hi, Maureen. Yes, please. A quiet one, if possible. We've got work to do.
Is that what they're calling it now? Speaking of work, Robert, someone reckon they could fix the roof themselves and, made it worse somehow. I mean, foot just went right through. No physical harm, thankfully.
The roof! Yes, I promised to take a look at it. Let me check out the damage real quick. Be right back.
Thanks, darling. Sure is one of the good ones right there.
He seems very nice, but I haven't actually talked to him longer than 10 minutes.
What's time got to do with anything? You know what you want when you see it, hon.
Yeah, we've got to get her arguing, haven't
we? Oh, Maureen, please. What do you take me for?
For a human being, of course. Don't go telling me city life turned you into a robot now. I don't buy it for a second. Anyway, let me show you to my nicest table. I hear the sun hits your face in all the right places here.
Okay, so what you're saying is there's a couple of things we can do, but no chainsaws.
Definitely no chainsaws, for the moment. It's just that the remaining options will take time, effort, and patience.
Well, that's one out of three for me.
Can I get you lovebirds? Anything else?
Maureen, really? I could always decide not to fix your roof today, you know.
Don't worry, Robert. I know Maureen. I'm sure she doesn't mean anything by it. A coffee refill would be nice. Thanks, Maureen.
Gotcha, hun. Robert?
The same for me, please.
Sure thing. Back in a jiff.
Ashley, is that coffee machine still running? They what?
Glad we're finally done for today. But there's more to come.
Do you think you'll manage?
What do you think?
To be honest, you probably need some extra help.
Is that an offer?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, you two hard-working individuals, here you go.
Thanks, Maureen. More coffee. How could anyone survive without it? So, how's life in P.O. so far?
It's only been a week, but... so far, so good.
Yeah, I've been here a bit longer. Time sure does fly.
I'm sure you must have some good stories.
Yeah, look, Meredith, I'm sorry. I really better get started on fixing that roof. It's just, that's quite
cold
a big
shoulder.
Well, it's still light out and all. You know, so, thanks so much for your help. I mean, I really do appreciate it. Drive home safe. I'll see you around town. So, yeah, I'll see you.
Cold shoulder,
Mr. Scott.
Everything okay
over here?
Yeah, I guess. I'm not sure.
Good day. My name is Walter Morgan. I'm from the Postal Service. I'm calling with regards to compliance to policies and guidelines, such as the use of Postal Service property, code of conduct, and so on. I will be in touch again soon.
Well, we didn't take letters and we've done no jobs for anybody.
Meredith, it's Steve.
Mr. Gog.
Oh, hi, Steve.
Thanks so much for improving the text and sending it back to me. I'm confident this will improve our chances of securing a monster deal.
You were hoping to get your monster deal, but you pulled out, mate.
It better help. It wasn't the most fun I've ever had.
You won't regret it. It's a monster deal. The big retailer, big money, big prizes.
Oh no, that's a bloody box, isn't it?
Calm down, Steve. And what happens now?
Well, yes, calmness is needed. Eyes on the prize. The next steps are me going to meet up with them this week. Discuss terms.
Okay, Steve. Good luck.
Thanks, Meredith. Speak soon.
Previously on Bon Appetit.
I have good news. Jean-Paul has agreed to become the chef of the downtown restaurant.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Rock and roll. There is only one problem. Jean-Paul is not a cook, but a car technician.
Well, I suppose if she gets that board in there on her own, she could rub a comb with a matchbox.
Good morning, Meredith. It's an envelope today with an incomplete address on it. It only says Mickey and June, Lake Campground, Providence Oaks. Do you think you can find that?
No, I can't.
I'm afraid not, Frank.
It's easy. Just drive past Jack Reynolds' land, and it appears on your right side on the lake shore.
Thanks. Oh, by the way, Frank, I wanted to ask you something.
I will not babysit Mildred's cats.
No, it's about something else. What's in those envelopes for you?
Oh, that's just for stamps. Saves them the hassle of driving up here. Hey, I gotta get back to work. Catch you later.
He's on the fiddle, isn't he? Yep, he's definitely on the bloody fiddle. That's why that post bloke rang up.
Morning, P.O. How about a pet peeve to start the weekend? Or will it be a positive? Tina Banks has the answer.
P.O. positive or pet peeve?
Jack, I have a pet peeve for here. We've got a beautiful lake and a nice boulevard, but why don't we have one of those coin-operated binoculars?
I like the idea, Tina. Let's take a closer look at today's weather now. A few clouds, but nothing but sunny skies in the end.
I love those water fountain things there, the water hyphens, whatever they are. Really cool. Main Street, where are we?
That's lighter than I thought.
They're all lighter than you thought, love.
Hi, Angie.
Oh, hey.
So, did things work out with the movie box?
Yeah, it was fine.
Listen, if you're busy, I can come back later.
Yeah, actually, now's not a great time. It's just... never mind. But in case you still want to help with the movie box, I have two more movies I'd like to see delivered. Jaws and The Dirty Dozen.
I still don't want to do it, Angie. Sorry.
Fine. It was a stupid idea anyway. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Bye.
Now she said she'd go back later. Does that mean she didn't drop the parcel, or she did? Don't think we have it, do we? Oh, Hydrant, thank you. Yes, she does run a cult, she does. Oh, it's not that one, isn't it? Oh, no, I go to the door, don't I? Sorry, guys, my mistake. Parcel.
Answer.
Yeah, we're not coming back. Sod that. Oh, there was one there. Look round the... was it? No, it's moving still. Oh, it was there, look. Oh, we'll get that on the way back to the post office, actually. So, we'll go right and we'll go here. So, over the river. And second right. So that looks like our last parcel, guys. Rest his letters.
Nope. No answer. All right. On to the next one.
Could be some Amazon thieves driving behind us picking all packages up. We'll be getting sacked.
These look like bills.
Is that a road there? Oh bugger, they keep bloody moving. Does sound like Friends, the start of that, doesn't it? Now then, whoops. Just look at the map, guys. Yeah, we can go this way around. I was just wondering how far that went over, but we can go that way around. Charming, very charming. Mr. Cook, you ought to get this. It is really, really sweet. Bobby, you ought to get this as well. It's brilliant. It is really calming, isn't it? Oh, we're here again.
Hi, Robert. Here's the mail.
Thanks, Meredith. And, sorry for leaving all of a sudden yesterday.
Should we let's be nice with him.
No problem. Leaking roofs don't fix themselves.
Well, it was just... I needed some space. I think I've gotten a bit too used to being on my own.
Was I such bad company?
No, not at all. I really enjoyed it. I just don't want you to feel weird about it. I was the weirdo.
There's nothing wrong with a little weirdness.
I just wanted you to know that. Anyways, let's see what's in the mail. A dentist appointment. Wait. Why am I sharing that with you?
So, no news regarding those apartments?
Nothing. Hallelujah. This gives me a bit more peace of mind to work on my wildcard plan.
Wildcard plan?
Wildcard plan. Yes. Also, highly confidential.
Oh, come on. I won't tell a soul.
Yeah, but no. Maybe later. It's still work in progress.
Okay. Good luck with that.
Thanks.
Poor bloke's really nervous, isn't he? He's not seen a woman in 6 years. Mr. Lumberjack, she's male woman's gonna eat you alive. Oh shit. The van's put out. Well, the sound has. Now then, is that one on the right, this letter we've got to take? He said on the right-hand side of the lake, didn't he? Yeah, I wonder if it snows in this game in winter. Just having a neb, guys. Can't get in. Nobody in, look. Got us peeping Toms through bloody window. Well, you've got to see things, haven't you? You don't have a neb, you don't know what's going on. Now then, there's nothing else up here, is there? No. Where are we going? That's the campground, isn't it? That's where we need to be. So, over the river and left. The nice thing about the game, you ain't got to worry about loads of traffic.
Witchcraft.
I remember Dad telling me, Meredith, the picnic area is for the older kids. I think I was 17 when I had my first actual picnic here. Hello there.
Heya, how are you?
I may have mail for you.
Is it addressed to Mickey or June? Or both?
To both. Here you go.
Oh, sweet brother Damien, savior in the hour of darkness.
Never mind him. He's a bit stressed out. We were a bit low on paper. Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Meredith.
A bit low nice on to toilet paper. Woo! Oh, she thought toilet paper as well.
Probably a bit of cash and some rolling paper.
Ah, that kind of paper. No harm in that.
Amen, sister. Thanks for the delivery.
You're welcome.
Get stoned, aren't they?
Nice RV, by the way. Is it yours?
Oh, thanks. Yeah, it's awesome. We borrowed it.
Joan, can you get in here, please? Now?
Oh, that's my cue. It was nice meeting you, sweet Meredith.
Can you, like, not tell the authorities your whole life story?
Hmm. Something going on there as well, isn't there? I'll tell you. Little town like this, it's all going on. Right, Meredith, where are we going? I think this is our last one, guys. So, back towards the post office. Can you get out this way? We can try it, can't we? This music is delicious. I love it. Really like it. Probably going to get screwed for copyright, but there you go.
That's the last of them.
Good lass, let's get you home.
Goodbye.
The Countess and the Carpenter? Really, Mom? Oh, well, let's give it a read.
The Countess and the Carpenter. Chapter 1. A more disastrous entry to her new home was scarcely imaginable for Cecilia Schultenbrau. The left wheel of her carriage collapsed, right as she entered through the gates of the magnificent Raubenstaben estate. She tumbled upside down, hurt her head, and worse, her hat was ruined. Suddenly, she heard the deep, strong voice of a young man. Are you all right, madam?
Hello?
You're speaking to Monster Deal Central. How may I help you?
Cooking mess. Yeah, he was pissed off she'd arrived, didn't she? Now then, is that Steve the Lumberjack?
I'm sorry, I'm not interested in telemarketing.
Meredith, silly, it's me, Steve. Please, tell me to calm down. We are so close to a deal. At 87, in shops all across America. Monster deal.
Calm down, Steve.
Okay. I met up with this big retailer, right? They read our great pitch. They loved it, and they want to buy 250,000 copies of At 87. 250,000. Multiply that by like $35.
That's a lot. But it's not a done deal yet, right?
Not yet, but oh so close. I can almost taste it. Listen, I've got the contract right here. I'm sending over a copy. You should have it tomorrow. Please, check it right away. I want your blessings before I sign on the dotted line, okay?
I'll see what I can do, Steve.
Awesome. I'll be in touch again Tuesday evening. I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it.
Brilliant.
It's official. I love horror movies.
A Nightmare on Elm Street is radical. It was amazing! Thank you for watching with me, Miss W.
You're welcome. I'm never going to sleep again.
Huh, maybe you shouldn't have watched the movie. Man, I wish my parents would let me watch these movies. I can't wait until I move out.
Yeah, well, I hope you had fun.
Yeah, I did. Maybe it's about time I convince my parents that I'm old enough. I'm almost an adult, and I don't want to wait until I've moved out until I can watch another horror movie.
Don't worry. We can always do this again sometime.
Yeah, I had fun. I hope you did too.
For sure. Maybe we can visit Angie's store and find a new movie to watch.
Oh, yeah. Totally. Good night, Miss W.
Oh, Steve's parcel. And another note from Tess. Hey, Em, here are Steve's contracts. I bet you're in the mood for some light reading. And now without sarcasm, really, I must admit the energy here is contagious. Is Addit actually going to take off? See you soon. Tess.
Good morning, Miss Weiss.
Good morning, sir. I didn't see you there.
The name's Walter Morgan. I'm with the Postal Service. I left you a message on your answering machine earlier this week.
Oh? I must have missed it.
Miss Weiss, if you could follow me into the office, I would like to ask you a few questions.
She's in trouble now.
Are you familiar with the Postal Service policies?
Of course we do.
Yes, well, the gist of it.
Can you remember the segment from Chapter 11, Section 3, first paragraph?
I'm sorry, that part seems to have slipped my mind.
It says in Chapter 11, Section 3, first paragraph, and I'll paraphrase, it is forbidden to use Postal Service property for personal gain.
Yes, very bad. Not good. Not good at all.
Miss Weiss, I'm aware that you've only just begun working here, but I trust that you do not take the responsibilities of a postal worker lightly.
If you look up the definition of integrity, it has my picture next to it.
The Postal Service puts its employees under the highest level of scrutiny. I advise you to answer the following three questions truthfully. A yes or no will suffice. Do you know Frank Coleman?
Yes.
Yes.
Have you ever given him envelopes or received envelopes from him that weren't postmarked?
Oh, God, what do we do? We can't snitch old Frankin, can we? Oh, we can, the old bastard. Let's get
yes.
it done.
Are you aware that Frank Coleman wages bets on baseball games?
Now, her dad said he did, but let's say we didn't.
No.
That will be all. Thank you for your cooperation.
We're in the shit now.
What's gonna happen to Frank?
I'm sorry. We can't discuss personnel matters. Good luck with the mail today, Miss Weiss.
Oh, guys, what have we done? Right, we're gonna leave it there. That's been an hour. Really cool, isn't it? Really enjoying it, I've got to admit. But as I said, I think an hour is about right. I think any longer than that and we'll all be numbstruck. Very, very nice, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Bobby, Mr. Cook, thank you for coming in. Guys on YouTube, you'll be watching this in a couple of days' time after we've recorded this on Thursday, so you'll probably get this on Saturday morning. Take care, guys. Lots of love, and I'll see you on the next one. Mr. Cook, Bobby, you are diamonds. Thank you so, so much, guys. Take care.